Gaano kalala ang damage na ginawa ni Ambo sa Eastern Samar?
Well, compared to other strong typhoons just like Yolanda and Bobby, this is, I think, hopefully has a lesser damage. But that is more worrisome or complicated in this problem is that we are also facing this COVID crisis here. We have converted all our evacuation centers into Ligtas COVID centers. So we cannot accommodate evacuation centers anymore because most of them are designed for one person only.
Okay, so...
So we have to bring the evacuation to the other classrooms, but we have also the challenge of how to observe social distancing. So this is a little bit complicated here.
Okay, do you have any message to the national government or to your friends, to our viewers who might want to help in the recovery? May mga shortages ba? Ano ang mga kailangan dyan? Paano makakatulong ang national government and the rest of the country, the Filipinos?
Salamat, Sito. Actually, sa ngayon po, ang urgent po namin pagkain sa mga evacuation centers. Ang normal na situation when there is a calamity, normally, the first line of defense that distributes food packs are the barangays and then after that, the national government comes in. But in this case, most of our food packs are already depleted because we have been distributing food packs since day one of the COVID crisis for almost 2 months already.
Gaano kalawak yung power outage dyan sa Eastern Samar and how soon will they be able to restore the power?
Well, kahapon po hanggang gabi, tuloy-tuloy po yung restoration. Kasi total blackout po kami yesterday. But in some areas now, there are already power. So hopefully, it will depend also on how that we damage these areas that are going to. So I don't know. But hopefully, ma-restore final of the day or tomorrow.
Okay, may panggastos ka pa ba, Governor? Kasi yung COVID-19 lang, most LGUs, most provinces, nasaid na yung kanilang resources. And given the expenditure for COVID-19, do you have any money left or funds left to address the damage or destruction caused by Typhoon Ambo on your province?
Well, that's a very good question. Actually, to be honest, talagang dito na rin talagang resources po namin. In fact, I had to rely on some of my budgets for other projects and programs for this COVID. So, nakatulong nga ito yung bigay ng Malacanang na one half equivalent ng 1 month rest namin. But despite of that, talagang kulang na po kami. We have to give up hazard pay to our frontliners. Maybe about 20 million we need to spend it for that. We're also giving 2,000 to the families who are not recipients of the social amelioration. And we need 60 million for that. At yung binigyan naman po ng Malacanang ng half na gira ng probinsya, binigay ko po sa mga hospital sa pangbita ng PPAs, ventilators, et cetera, et cetera, ng mga COVID-related items po. So, talagang, to be honest, we are already starting to fund. Pero hopefully, we'll be able to manage this.